Now read 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 16.
彼得后书, 第三章,
let's even see what Peter said about Paul.
我们看看, 保罗, 彼得怎样讲保罗?
2 Peter chapter 3, let's read verse 15 and 16.
彼得后书第三章,
15 and 16.
15-16节, 并且要我, 主长久忍耐为不救的恩由。
Now, you will see here that Peter himself acknowledged that some of the revelations of Paul was too hard to be understood.
你留意到這裡, 連彼得都是, 承認, 保羅所得的啟示, 是很難明白的。
Now, in fact, he said they were so hard that some people, in trying to understand the revelation of Paul, they were giving themselves problems.
難到一個地步, 有些人想明白, 保羅的啟示, 其實呢, 為他們自己帶來麻煩。
So at that point,
所以在那個點呢,
it is natural pride we want to come in.
在那個點裡面呢, 很自然, 那個驕傲就來到。
For example,
例如,
the disciples, Jesus taught them Holy Communion.
門徒呢, 神, 將, 聖餐教他們。
But according to 1 Corinthians 11, Paul said nobody taught him. He got Holy Communion by revelation.
保罗在, 臨前11章就說, 沒有人教他, 聖餐的, 即是神給他的啟示。
Most of the things that the other apostles knew, it was Jesus that taught them.
因為其餘的使徒所認識的, 全部都是耶穌教導的。
Paul did not meet Jesus.
保羅是沒有跟耶穌面對。
He was still a young child.
當時他還是一個很小的小孩子。
And he ended up knowing more than them.
但是結果保羅所得到的啟示是比他們還要多。
By revelation.
是啟示是比他們還要多。
Now, read with me Acts of Apostles.
讀《使徒行傳》。
Acts of Apostles chapter 26.
26章。
Just a minute, please. 20 is verse 20. Let's read 20. I just want to show you some things about the revelation of Paul. All the things, you know, we read about Holy Communion yesterday. If you read that portion of the Bible, Paul said, nobody taught him. It was Jesus that taught him. Read Acts chapter 20.
使徒行傳20章。
Read verse 35.
35節。 我凡事給你們作榜樣，叫你們知道應當這樣勞苦，輔助軟弱的人。 又當紀念主耶穌的話，說施比受更為有福。
Now, he was quoting what Jesus said, but Paul did not meet Jesus.
他是講緊, 耶穌, 所講的東西, 但保羅是從耶穌沒有見過面的。
And the Gospels were not yet written then, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
福音書當時其實都未寫的。
So, where did Paul get all these things from?
那保羅究竟在哪裡, 得到這些, 耶穌所講的說話呢?
Jesus told him.
耶穌告訴他聽,
by revelation.
是藉著啟示,
please, when you get home again, read 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 1 to 9.
讀, 哥林初前書15章1至9節。
There you will see the things that Jesus told Paul.
你就會看到, 那裡呢, 耶穌是將一些事告訴保羅聽的。
So pride began to come. I mean, naturally, pride will come.
所以很自然地呢, 他有這樣的啟示, 那個驕傲就會來到。
He said, therefore,
所以,
God had to give him a thorn in the flesh.
所以神必須將一根刺加在他的肉身上。
Today,
今天,
there are people that just have a little revelation.
今天呢, 有些人只是, 有很少的啟示,
and they are so proud.
他就已經很驕傲。
My church is the biggest in Hong Kong.
我呢就是香港最大的教會。
I have more revelation than everybody in Hong Kong.
我比香港任何人都有更多的啟示。
Just little revelation.
即是很少的啟示。
Imagine a man that has so much revelation.
想象下一个有咁多启示嘅人。
Now, what was the thorn in the flesh?
咁究竟一根肉身上嘅一根刺系指咩
咧 ？Now, he already said at the time of his conversion, the Holy Spirit already said that he will suffer grievously.
當他初決志信主的時候，聖靈已經跟他說他會受很大的苦。
And I will show you from the scriptures.
我會在聖經裡面告訴大家。
But listen to this.
但要聽住。
You will notice that in spite of the revelations of Paul.
即使保羅的有這樣的啟示呢。
And in spite of the power that flows through his ministry.
即使他的事工裏面是大有能力
he demonstrated so much power of God.
他因為他顯示出他神藉著他是顯示
出 so many miracles happen.
很多神跡是發生的
But you will notice that whenever Paul gets to a city,
但你會留意當保羅去到一個地方的時候
preach,
一城市去傳道的時候
miracles will happen.
神跡會發生
he will establish a church.
他會建立教會
and after he does that.
當他做完咁樣做完之後咧，
The Jews will come,
個猶太人會嚟
，stir the people against Paul,
叫啲人咧去敵對保羅
，and they start stoning Paul,
就要掟啲石仔去敵對佢
，Paul will run away,
保羅就必須逃跑
，run to another city,
就要逃退另外一個城市
，preach powerfully,
又再好有能力咁去
，miracles will happen,
神蹟會發生
，establish a church,
建立教會。
Then the Jews will hear.
嗰啲猶太人又聽到。
Paul is there again.
保羅喺嗰度。
They will run there.
佢哋又要走去嗰度。
Stir up the people against him.
叫啲人咧去反對保羅。
And they will want to kill Paul.
嗰啲人又想去殺保羅。
In fact, somewhere they have to let him through a window by basket.
有一次咧佢要喺窗度用個籃子吊佢落嚟。
There was a time they even stoned Paul. Paul died. The brethren prayed for him, and he came back to life again.
甚至他被石头打死，他死了，有人为他祷告，他又复活。
Now, how can you imagine?
你可不可以想象
？Somebody has just done a powerful crusade.
有人啱啱做完一个咁有能力嘅布道会。
Even for those of us that are just believing God, you know, in our ministry, we go around preaching.
即使啱啱信啦，嚟之后传道。
You know, when you preach,
当你传道嘅时候
，and there is revival.
又有复兴啦。
You are so happy.
你就好開心㗎。
And now, at the time when the man should be happy and say, praise God, oh, there was powerful crusade.
當你想慶祝話好讚美主啊，有個好偉大嘅佈道會嘅時候
，they will start stoning him.
佢哋就開始用石掟佢啦。
Now, if you are Paul, if you are Paul,
你想象假如你係保羅
，what will you think?
你會點諗咧
？God, this problem is too much.
呢啲問題真係太難頂啦。
Today everybody likes you and hails you.
今日個個中意你又抬舉你。
And once he has established the church,
但係當佢建立教會嘅時候
，problem will start.
個問題難題就嚟啦。
That was why he said three times I've asked God, Lord, I don't like this side of it.
所以佢話有三次佢求主話我唔中意一樣嘢。
He said what God said, my grace is sufficient for you.
但係神同佢講。我嘅恩典夠你啦。
Now go to that Second Corinthians 11 again.
我哋去到臨後第十一章。
Second Corinthians 11。
臨後第十一章。
Now read verse 10。
讀第十節。
Sorry, Second Corinthians 12. Sorry.
我對唔住。係臨後第十二章。
Verse
10。第十節。我為基督的緣故。
Now I want you to read two translations here.
我喺度要睇一睇兩個譯本。
For the sake of Christ, not because of lack of faith. For the sake of Christ, I'm well pleased and take pleasure in infirmities, insults, hardships, persecutions, perplexities, distresses. For when I am weak in human strength.Then I'm truly strong, able, powerful in divine strength. So verse 10 explains what the thorn in the flesh is.
其實呢個第十節係解釋咗乜嘢嘢 是肉体上的恩赐。
The thorn in the flesh is because for the sake of Christ。
个肉体上的一根刺是必须是为了基督的缘故。
And he called them infirmity. Infirmity means physical weakness。
呢度系讲到系身体上的软弱，系有病。
It also means limitation。
身体上软弱或者一啲限制。
It also means disability。
亦都可以话一啲残缺。
Right. So it was not talking about sickness。
唔系讲紧病。
He had disabilities. Also, even with finances, Paul had problems.
对唔住，系disability 系一啲唔能够做嘅嘢，有啲嘢唔能够做。
Do you know that Paul established so many churches?
你知唔知保罗系建立咗好多教会
？It was only the church in Philippi that sent him offering.
只有腓立比教会嘅先会将奉献送俾佢。
In all the other places, when he goes to establish church, he will have to work with his hands.
其余的教会当他建立的时候，他要自己。
But when Peter and James and other people go to those churches, they give them offerings.
当彼得或者雅各去建立教会的时候，他们有收到奉献的。
But Paul, who labored over those churches, didn't get no offering.
但是保罗为这些教会劳苦的时候，他没有收到任何奉献。
And in 2 Corinthians chapter 9,Paul had to talk about it. I believe at that point, Paul couldn't take it no more.
喺臨後第九章，其實保羅好公開咁講呢樣嘢。我諗到嗰段時候咧，保羅真係忍受唔住。
And you know Paul was not married, so he had to say, "Is it because he's not married that they don't give him offering like Peter, who was married?"
佢就講大家知道保羅冇結婚啦，可能咧就係佢就話或者因為我冇結婚啦，你就唔同你哋對彼得佢有個妻子。
Paul was not referring to sickness。
保羅唔係講疾病。
If he was referring to sickness, he would have mentioned it。
如果係講到係疾病嘅時候咧，佢又咁樣講。
He had a lot of insults。
佢有好多嘅羞辱。
Hardships。
困難。
Persecution。
逼迫
distresses
壓力好困難
he had a shipwreck
佢曾經經歷過沉船
three times he was beaten by the Romans
佢被羅馬人打鞭打三次
so many hardships that he went through
佢經歷過好多嘅困難
those are the things he called thorns in the flesh
呢啲就係佢所稱為嘅肉身上嘅恩賜
right now let's go again to Acts chapter 20Yeah,
2023. 使徒行传二十章廿三节，但知道圣灵在各城里向我指证，说有捆锁与患难等待我。
Now he said every city he goes to, the Holy Spirit even tells people. This was when he was going to Jerusalem, that a lot of problems are waiting for him.
当佢去耶路撒冷嘅时候，佢话每一个城市去嘅时候，圣灵都话俾佢听有捆锁有困难等紧佢。
If you are Paul, will you go? The Holy Spirit is already saying, if you go to Jerusalem, you're going to have a lot of problems.
假如你想象下，你系保罗，如果圣灵话俾你听你去耶路撒冷，你有好多问题，你会唔会去咧
？Paul still went.
但系保罗都一样去。
Because he was used to problems.
因为佢咧就好习惯嗰啲难题。
Read verse 24. Read verse 24.
读第廿四节。我卻不以聖靈為念，成就我從主耶穌所領受的職事，證明神恩惠的。
Now you will see, sir, I'm not moved by all these things. I'm used to them already.
呢度保罗系讲到呢啲事咧，都系唔会摇动我嘅心，因为我系惯咗。
Please, when you go home, I want you to read those references I gave.
我想你翻屋企咧，系读我头先所叫你睇嘅经文。
I want you to read those references.
我想你睇嗰啲经文。
You know, so that you can have better understanding.
以致你能够有清楚嘅认识。
Right. So the thorn in the flesh was not sickness.
所以肉身上嘅一根刺唔系疾病。
It was the problems Paul was having everywhere he went.
是保罗去到无论去哪一地方他都遇到的困难。
Read 2 Corinthians chapter 6.
读林后第六章。
Read 2 Corinthians chapter 6.
林后第六章。
Let's read from verse 3.
第三节。
To 10.
到第十节。
Let's see what happened. 3 to 10.
3至10節，我們凡事都不叫人有妨礙，免得這職份被人毀謗，反倒在各樣的事上表明自己是神的用人，就如在很多的忍耐、患難和難。
Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 11.
林後第十一章。
2 Corinthians chapter 11.
林後第十一章。
Now, let's see where Paul now, at the point Paul had to open up, hey, you guys, what's going on here? Is it because I'm not talking?
看到呢，保羅在這裡呢，都要很坦白地去講，就說你們的人究竟在做什麼呢？
Because Paul now realized that, hey, when he goes to these churches, they don't give him offering. And when Peter goes, when Paul, James goes, when other people go, they give them offering, they take care of them. He established the churches. Please, when you get home, I want you to read from verse 1 to verse 15.
我想你回到家就读十一章的一至十五节。
But for the purpose of our study, let us just read from verse 16 to 27.
因为我们的时间缘故，我们就读。
I mean, to verse 29, sorry.
16 to 29. 我哋就读第十六到廿九节。
16 to 29, let's read.
我哋一齐读。我再说，人不可当作愚妄，虽然如此，也必可当愚妄人接纳，叫我可以略略自夸。我说的16 to 29，实际系话不是奉主名说，乃是像愚妄人放胆自夸。既然有好些人任凭有意自夸，我也要自夸了。你们既是精明人，就能甘心忍耐愚妄人。假如有人向你着急，大家一起到第三十節。我若必須自夸，就那包含乎我軟弱的事了。
Now you will realize that all the things he mentioned here, he called them infirmities.
你留意到咧，佢講嘅呢度講嘅嘢咧，佢就叫 infirmities。
So infirmity, what did he say in Chinese? Verse 30.
軟弱嘅事。
Weakness. Right. Now, the same word used there is what is used in verse 12, infirmity.
是同一个字是用在第十二节。
Now, he gave us the resume of what he had been through.
他给我们一个介绍，即是好像一个履历书咁样。
Now, he said, look, all these people that you now give offerings, you give a lot of money, you take care of them, He said, if they are Hebrews, I'm also a Hebrew.
佢就話：你誒嗰啲人，你哋咁樣去照顧佢啦，俾佢 offer 奉獻啦，但係佢哋係希伯來人，我都係。
He said, if they are ministers of God, I am more.
啊，假如佢哋係神嘅仆人，我更加係。
Then he began to tell us all that he had gone through.
啊，佢就開始話俾我哋聽佢所經歷嘅嘢。
And in verse 29,
喺第29節
，he now referred to weakness.
啊，佢係用軟弱。
And then in verse 30.
在第十三節
They now call it infirmity or weakness.
啊，佢係用英文係用另外一字，但係中文係用軟弱。
Now I need to say this to you first of all.
啊，我先話俾你聽。
In the original text of the Bible, both Hebrew and Greek, the New Testament, there was no chapters. It was just a book.
啊，我想話俾大家聽，喺聖經嘅原文咧，希伯來文或者希列文咧，係冇分章節章段落嘅。
It was the Bible translators who put them into chapters.
啊，係嗰啲聖經嘅翻譯嘅人咧，將佢分成一章章嘅。
So Paul was continuing his statement.
其實保羅係一氣呵成咁樣講。
The Bible translators put it in chapters so that people can understand.Imagine if everything is just one book. You don't know where you are reading.
啊，啲人將佢分章段落咧，係讓人可以明白。因為如果成好長咁樣樣，大家都唔知自己讀到邊。
So he was still talking about the same. It was still the same statement he was making. The same speech.
其實係佢係講緊同一樣嘅嘢嘅一個翻話嚟嘅。
And he had told us here what is infirmity, what is weakness.
呢度佢係話緊俾我哋聽，佢講嘅軟弱係乜嘢嘢
？So as he went ahead, he now began to mention in chapter 12. So it's the same speech.
啊，所以佢繼續係第十二章嗰度咧，係講緊同一個説話嚟嘅。
So it is clear that it is not sickness.
所以好清晰，保羅所指嘅唔係疾病。
It was the problems that he went through.
就係佢經歷過嘅一切嘅困難。
Now, why did Satan misinterpret this scripture in the church?
點解撒旦令到教會誤解一段經文咧
？You see, Satan is smart.
撒旦好精明，好叻嘅。
For people to be under the bondage of sickness.
要啲人係被疾病去捆綁嘅時候咧
，If they could see that a man like Paul.Was having a sickness in his body.
假如佢哋諗咧，保羅保羅咁樣樣嘅人都喺佢身體有軟有疾病咧
，then they will not be able to release their faith. So if they are sick, they say, "Well, even if Paul God gave him sickness, who am I?"
咁咧，佢就會留唔能夠釋放佢嘅信心，因為保羅咁樣樣嘅人都有病，何況我咧
？So Satan had to stylishly look for a way to convince people that Paul too was sick.
所以咧，撒旦要揾一個方法咧，去令到人覺得保羅係有病。
And he even prayed three times, and God refused to heal him.
即使佢禱告三次咧，神都唔醫治佢。
So they say, "Who am I?"
咁話我係邊個咧
？But you can realize now that it is a lie of the devil.
你而家要知道這個係魔鬼嘅謊話。
Then I always say this to people.
我時時都咁同人講。
Paul said the reason why God allowed that problem in his life was because of the abundance of revelation.
保羅成日話神容許啲軟弱喺佢身上，係因為佢所得嘅啟示係幾咁豐富。
Okay, let's assume that it was evil sickness.
我哋假定呢個係一個疾病。
It's because of the revelation he has, so that I won't be proud.
是因為他有的啟示太多，以致他唔神想去驕傲。
Let me ask you, how much revelation do you have?
我哋問下大家自己，究竟我哋自己有幾多嘅啟示咧
？That will make you to want to be proud.
令到咧，你可以好似保羅咁去驕傲咧。
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I hope the question is clear now.
我希望咧呢個問題咧係清楚。
Paul was not carrying any sickness.
保羅唔係帶住任何嘅疾病。
It was the problems of the ministry, and it was only Paul that had that problem.
呢個係咧佢喺事工上嘅困難，而唯有保羅咧先係面對緊呢啲困難。
The churches were not taking care of him.
因為個教會冇看顧到保羅。
And you know he was not married.
因為佢知道佢冇結婚。
They were giving offering to those pastors that were married. He didn't give him offering, and he was the one that started the churches.
啲教會咧係只係將奉獻咧俾嗰啲結咗婚嘅牧者，而即使保羅係開展呢啲教會咧，佢哋都冇理佢。
So when the church in Philippi gave him offering.That was why he prayed in Philippians 4:19, My God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory through Christ.
因為只有腓立比教會係將奉獻帶俾佢，所以佢喺腓立比書入邊話讚美主係和有神係供應佢一切嘅所需。